We're joined now by John Meyer, analyst at Fairfax, who's going to talk us through some of the stocks that he's been looking at. John, welcome. Thanks very much indeed for joining us. Let's start with DiamondCorp, and it's a company that we've been talking to today. Let's check with the relationship. You're the broker on this particular firm, but you're quite keen on them.
Yes, it's an enterprising company. It's looking to develop a new diamond mine in South Africa, one of very few new mines in the diamond sector in recent years. And it looks like it's going to be quite a good one.
They're in Botswana as well. Does that help or does that confuse?
Well, it helps to fill in the story when perhaps some of the news flow from the Southern African operations is slow. So there is ongoing exploration in Botswana and that might come up with something good.
Now, you've got a buy recommendation with a target price of 17p and you're describing them at the current 8p area as distressed. Are you expecting this to go up quite rapidly?
It has been a very distressed share and in fact, it's been held back by a trading situation where an investor who I think was quite distressed sold a block of stock to a market maker who's just sat on it. And I think there is a raft of shareholder support here that really wants to take that out and lift the shares higher.
And when you wrote your report on them, you highlighted a lot of M&A activity in that sector. Is that something that's likely to affect DiamondCorp or is it just an interesting sidebar to what's going on?
Well, yes, there is more of that going on and we've seen diamond prices rise following a collapse during the global financial crisis when Lehman's went down, and that's quite compelling. But looking further forwards, there is going to be this supply shortage of diamonds in the world. Generally, actually, whatever happens to the global economy, people carry on buying diamonds, carry on getting married. That was surprisingly uninterrupted. The problem that happened was the deleveraging of credit to diamond dealers. Now, that's unlikely to happen again to the same degree. Those diamond dealers have been largely deleveraged anyway. So diamond prices are seen as much more stable than they were.
Okay, so that's DiamondCorp, so that's a clear buy. Let's move on to EMED Mining. Now, this is a bit more of a conglomerate, if you like, in terms of what they're into, in terms of geographically and what they're mining for. Any relationship there, first of all?
No, none whatsoever right at this stage.
So what's interesting about this particular company?
Well, They would like to tell you that they've got a great gold discovery and that looks very good in Europe. And I would sort of prefer to focus on some of their other operations. They own the license over the Rio Tinto mine in Spain. This is the original Rio Tinto copper mine. It's been going for thousands of years. And I think it's going to get a new lease of life. There is still a lot of copper there. And as Rio Tinto, the major company, recently said, the best place to find a copper mine is around an old one. And this is particularly the case here. Copper prices are so much higher than they were. Margins are very much better. All they need to do is sort out a couple of licensing issues and they are away. The plant is in place, the processing plant, much of the equipment is there. $50 million, $100 million, and you're into production within the next year.
The chief executive is a very confident man. He's been saying so in the press recently, but the share price is down to 9 from 15. Is this now a good opportunity to get in, do you think?
Well, I think that, yes, this is a distressed issue. It's one of the few stocks that's been overlooked. They had a few permitting problems in Spain, and I really think they've got through most of that now, and the government seems hugely supportive of the current management team. So for us, yes, you might have to wait a little while for the shares to react, but I think they will start to react quite soon.
Okay, let's move on to Medusa Mining. Relationship is?
We're Nomad and Broker here.
Okay, and this is staying with gold, but this is slightly further afield. This is in the Philippines.
This is a personal favourite, and I think it's a good recommendation for private shareholders. It's got very, very low industry costs. They produce gold at often under $200 an ounce. Even if that comes up a bit, it's going to be no more than $300 an ounce. That gives you an operating margin of $1,000 an ounce at today's gold prices. That's amazing by any standards. They have a lot of gold developed in underground workings. Very easy to pull that to surface to increase production rates. They're already producing at around 100,000 ounces a year. So it's very easy to do the maths on this. 100,000 ounces a year at $1,000 an ounce is $100 million a year of operating margin.
So this is effectively a company that's not really affected by the gold price as long as it stays above 1,000, and you'd have to have a crash for that to happen.
And to add to that, they're moving from AIM onto the main board, so we might get a re-rating in the stock at the same time.
Okay. Our final stock then, Discovery Metals. Now we're on to copper, but this is in Botswana. Why are you looking at that? Oh, first of all, relationship.
Yes, we are Nomad and Broker again.
Okay. So what's grabbing your attention on this one?
Well, we love Botswana. It's a very easy country to operate in. You can get your mining permit very easily, and frankly, the environment in Botswana is one that is extremely conducive to mining. Copper grades looking quite good. It's going to be a new mine. Will be financed quite soon through the marketplace, and I think this is a developing story. It's, the more holes they put into the ground in Botswana, the better it gets, and the grades are pretty good. So it's been a very slow burn to get to this point now, and I think it will turn itself into a producing unit in the next 18 months to 2 years.
Okay, so this is a definite buy opportunity again.
It is at this stage.
Okay, John Meyer from Fairfax, thanks very much indeed for joining us once again today.
Thank you.